Way back in 2005, future Kick-Ass helmer Matthew Vaughn was supposed to direct the third X-Men movie for Fox. For a variety of reasons, the relationship didn't work out. Instead, the film wound up being directed by Brett Ratner, a filmmaker of such singularly limited ability that his sole noteworthy achievement as director has been to make Jackie Chan unexciting three times in a row. The resulting film, X-Men: The Last Stand, was even worse than anyone could have imagined. A horrid, wretched, offensively awful piece of shit that drove the series into the ground, and was spared the everlasting indignity of being the worst thing that ever happened in the 40-year history of the X-Men franchise only by the virtue of X-Men Origins Wolverine somehow being even worse. Now, 7 years later, Matthew Vaughn and producer Bryan Singer have come charging back to attempt the impossible, bring the X-Men back from oblivion with First Class, a prequel set in the mid-1960s that reveals the birth of the team and in particular the origins of Professor X, Magneto, and their doomed friendship. It's a bold move for Fox, who need to keep the series alive lest Marvel Studios start taking their toys back, and a huge risk for Vaughn, gambling his still-fledgling reputation on a franchise that couldn't be more dead. And he's hit it out of the f***ing park. First Class is not only better than all of the previous X-Men movies, it easily jumps close to the top of the entire superhero subgenre. No, it's not quite in the league of my personal top three, but it's not as compromised and self-ashamed about its comic book origins as the original X films. It doesn't have the problematic second act of Iron Man 2 or the non-existent third act of Iron Man 1, and it has a little more intellectual heft than the otherwise perfectly serviceable Thor. I don't think it's an exaggeration at all to say that First Class belongs right up there with The Dark Knight. Yes, it's that good. As to the story, it's the 1960s, and the superhuman mutants aren't yet widely known about, but James McAvoy's young Oxford professor-slash-mutant telepath Charles Xavier has a utopian dream of integrating his kind into society peacefully. Michael Fassbender's Eric Lencher, a Holocaust survivor with the mutant power to control magnetism, has a much bleaker outlook, but they become friends as part of a rogue CIA project to thwart the Hellfire Club, a group of mutant supervillains with a mad plan to trick America and the Soviet Union into starting World War III. Xavier thinks their heroism will make the world accept mutants, while Eric has a personal score to settle with Kevin Bacon as the club's leader, Sebastian Shaw. The events that unfold will ultimately decide the course of both men's lives, for good or for ill. Let's get this part out of the way. Yes, this is more or less an in-continuity prequel to the other films, hence why most of the more popular well-known characters aren't around yet. And while there are some minor hey-wait-a-minute hiccups in terms of timeline and inter-character relationships, it all lines up very well with what you remember of the two good X-Men movies. The Last Stand and Wolverine, on the other hand, appear to now be completely erased from existence. To explain how would be a bit of a spoiler, but several big story turns in First Class essentially negate major parts of those two. So, yeah, it's not just a good movie in its own right, it's a good movie that actually deletes two bad movies. How cool is that? The Cold War setting and spy game skullduggery automatically suggest more than a little influence of Golden Age James Bond, and that the film embraces that aesthetic is one of the fundamental reasons why it works so well. The dreary blue-gray visuals of the original films are here tossed aside in favor of a vibrant mod palette that, for the first time, makes an X-Men movie look like an X-Men movie. The action scenes are big and inventive, with literally dozens of oddball characters zipping around using their powers, but it all feels real and immediate in addition to just being fun. And the cast is really, really good, particularly the two leads, and especially Michael Fassbender. It's kind of a deviously brilliant choice for the film to make the one we know is going to wind up as the bad guy Magneto be the more charismatic and traditionally heroic of the two, while letting Xavier's relentless starry-eyed idealism play out as naive and more than a little insufferable in this context, however well-meaning. Among the younger actors, Jennifer Lawrence continues to be a revelation as the young Mystique, and Nicholas Holt is a terrific beast. On the bad guy side, Jason Fleming makes a serious impression as the enigmatic Azazel, and Kevin Bacon is always fun in stuff like this. On the less enthusiastic side, while January Jones is a stunning presence as Emma Frost, she doesn't seem to have a lot of range, though I don't begrudge anyone who finds it difficult to notice that right away. But the main thing holding it together is that the series is once again in the hands of filmmakers who can handle the mix of big-scale action and genuine intelligence that the franchise demands. Regrounding the series in the earnest yet complex allegory for civil rights, conformity, and social misfits that's made it more than just another superhero comic from the very beginning. Look, I know, after the last two, it's not easy to get excited about an X-Men movie, but First Class is one of the year's must-see films, and it'd be a genuine tragedy if this excellent movie wound up paying for the sins of its predecessors. Check this one out. See you next time.